Brainstorming is a technique or it's a strategy through which we generate large number of ideas for solving any problem. What are the brainstorming techniques? Here are some techniques. The basic idea remains common, that you generate large number of ideas and then you evaluate and make the number very small. You select the best one. Now, on the basis of that, we can have various techniques. Some of these techniques are mentioned here: nominal group technique, round robin brainstorming technique, brain writing technique, and mind mapping. Nominal group technique is used to prioritize or rank the ideas generated. So, ideas are already generated now in a big class, and now we have to shortlist some of the best ideas, and for that we use nominal group technique. These ideas which are generated, they are generated anonymously, as we know that there is no name of the person who has given this idea. So, all the ideas generated are anonymous. The teacher collects all the generated ideas. Students rank the generated ideas based on some selected criteria. Now, these criteria can be, say, cost, the criterion can be time, the criterion can be human, the criteria could be people available to solve this problem. So, you can judge the criteria, and using those criteria, the students can rank the generated ideas. Teacher conducts discussion with students to reevaluate ideas with the highest rank. Now, many groups have worked. In a group of, say, you have 40 students in a class and group of 5 or 6 students in a members sitting in one group, you may have 7 to 8 groups. Now, everyone has given the ranks. Now, again, you can have a discussion with all 40 students, with all 7, 8 groups to rank, to re-evaluate the ideas and give them the ranks. And so that the first 2 or 3 ranking ideas can be selected for actual taking action. This is called a nominal group technique. In this technique, you have seen that anonymity is more important. Anonymity, that means there is no name given to idea, and these ideas are given to the groups to work on the ranking assignment, and that's why this technique helps in reducing dominance of a particular group or a particular student. And everyone feels free to give their opinion in ranking the ideas. Anonymity encourages the students for equal participation, because people should not feel threatened that this was my idea and everyone is criticizing, or how can I criticize somebody else's idea. That fear, that inhibition is not there, because the idea does not have a name. It is anonymously these ideas are collected. The second technique of brainstorming is called round robin brainstorming session. Here students sit in a group, and number of members in a group can be 4 to 6. That is called an ideal number. In this group, the students generate ideas. This is a small group, and instead of generating ideas in 40 students class, here the ideas are generated in a small group of 4 to 6. In that group, one student notes down all the ideas given by all group members. And as we have seen in a large class, here also, till the students get exhausted with all the ideas, this continues. They can work. Of course, you can suggest the time that we will do this brainstorming for 30 minutes or 20 minutes. Students will come out with ideas, and there would be one point of time that students feel, no more ideas, I am exhausted. So, till they get exhausted, these ideas are generated. You will see here that students are generating ideas in a small group. The group size is 4 to 6. Can you see a difference? Is a small group generating ideas, and there is a big group of 40. The whole class is generating ideas together. So, there is a difference. There is no comparison. Many more ideas come up when you sit together in a bigger group. But there may be sometimes a condition or a situation where you may think that it is appropriate to have a small group, generate ideas, evaluate them, and then come back to the whole class. That is also possible. So it is up to you to select a technique, appropriate technique for your topic, for your condition, for the situation. The third type of technique is mind mapping. You must have read about mind mapping in a different context, where we write concepts or we write ideas in a map. But this map is called mind mapping because the ideas which come to your mind are put on the board or put on the paper. This technique also can be used as a technique of brainstorming. What is the beauty of mind mapping? Yes, the students write their ideas on the blackboard or a piece of paper, but how they are written is different. We have seen that the ideas can be stuck or ideas can be written on the board in any manner. But in mind mapping, we don't do that. The topic is written in the center, and if you think that the ideas getting generated have some kind of groups, so then you can put different branches to this main topic, and the ideas as they get generated, you write those ideas into those branches. There can be sub branches, some ideas go into those sub branches. So it looks like it doesn't look like a tree because it is not a straight up and then branches. Here it is full of web with some topic in the center and branches and sub branches around it. For every sub branch, there would be some kind of idea. The students write these associated words or ideas as appropriate in those branches or those sub branches. In mind mapping, the topic which is written in the center and it branched out in say 4 or 5 different branches, this can be called as categories. And it is easier as you are just putting those words in those categories. It is easier for us at the evaluation stage to evaluate those ideas on the basis of some kind of criteria. One more technique used in brainstorming is called brain writing. Here also students sit in group, say group of 5 or 6, because that is the ideal number. Each group member works for 5 minutes. The topic is given, they work for 5 minutes. They write down, each member writes down 3 ideas on the paper. And after 5 minutes, that paper is given to the next member. So it rotates. Another member again reads that and adds his or her own ideas based on that. Now every group member has already written 3 ideas, but as you see others' ideas also, you feel like developing, contributing to that idea as well. So the whole paper again gets a lot of ideas and it works. In a group of 6, one person has written, next person has written, person has added. By the time it goes to the 6th person, you can see that there are 18 to 20 ideas which are generated. And now this becomes a base for selecting the best idea out of this. You will see that in the whole process of brainstorming, teacher's role is very important. What is the role the teacher should play? Here the basic idea is generating lot of ideas for attacking a problem. So instructions are very important. How we should go about? We have seen the rules of the game. So the role of a teacher is to give clear-cut instruction. Say for example, at the time of brainstorming, no more evaluation, no assessment, no judgment. It's a very important instruction. The teacher must make it very clear that you only generate ideas at this point of time. He or she also must ensure that the atmosphere is uninhibited. There are no inhibition, there are no restrictions. Students should feel free. So how to give those instructions is also a technique. The teacher should create that kind of environment, congenial environment, inviting environment, so that students should feel free to contribute. Important role of a teacher is while conducting the brainstorming session, there are clear-cut 2 stages. One is generating ideas and other is evaluating the ideas. We should not mix these two up. Teacher must be very clear where to stop generation of ideas, and then either in small group or a bigger group, how to evaluate the ideas without giving this feeling that my idea was of no use. We have to use criteria, and on the basis of those criteria, the teacher must help the students to evaluate, assess the ideas, and select the best possible solutions to solve the problem. Here, that is why the role of a teacher is very important. It may happen that when you select a topic, the topic is written on the board. Now, student starts giving the ideas, but it may happen that some students are going in different directions. The teacher must be alert and immediately bring the students back to track. This is also an important role of a teacher, that we should not get distracted. The main characteristic or main feature of brainstorming is it is focused strategy. The problem is identified and it is focused efforts to solve that problem. So, teacher must be alert and keep the students on the track. He or she also must tell the students how much time we have in hand. So, 30 minutes, 40 minutes, 1 hour, whatever time once we suggest, those ideas can be contributed during that time. But we cannot go on and on. It is another feature of brainstorming is that it is time bound. And students do come out in a given time slot. This time should be adequate enough. One more important role of a teacher is that the teacher should see that every student is contributing significantly in the whole process. Some students may feel shy in contributing or saying aloud their own ideas so that others should not ridicule those, but teacher should give them the courage, the confidence that their contribution is also valued. That is an important role of a teacher. Let's see the advantages of brainstorming. We have seen that brainstorming promotes thinking without any constraint or inhibition. That is the first prerequisite, and this is the advantage of it. It helps in removing social or psychological blocks from the minds of students, because right from the beginning we are saying you have to contribute your ideas towards solving this problem. So, there are no inhibitions. Any wild, any weird idea can be put forward by the students. Please remember that it is not judged or evaluated at that point of time. And that's why the student gets confidence to come out with some more new ideas. If you use brainstorming quite often, automatically a conducive environment for learning gets prepared. It's not teacher dominated classroom anymore. It is the learner centered environment which is created because of use of brainstorming strategy. Brain based learning is a new thought in education which has as its base a neurological research. Neurological research tells us lot many things about how brain learns, and the brain learns better in cooperative and collaborative environment. So, naturally brainstorming strategy is fully based on brain based learning thoughts. This strategy also develops critical thinking ability in our students, but in a cooperative manner. It's not individual thought process. Yes, ultimately the thought is of that individual, but other members in the group help him or her as sounding boards. That is more important. This strategy gives that opportunity for every student who participates in this strategy. If this strategy is used quite often by the teachers, you will see a difference that student has gained lot of self-confidence, because the ideas are accepted as they are without evaluation, without assessing. We are not saying this is wonderful ideas, we are not saying this is a trash. The idea is accepted as it is, has a tremendous effect on the self-confidence of the student, and this strategy provides that. Since we invite all the students to participate in this process, since we give importance to everybody's contribution to the problem solving, a kind of democratic environment is created in the class, and that democratic value is inculcated in students. What are these values? to listen to others, to respect others' contribution, to try to influence others in a most sophisticated manner, not aggressively, but assertively. All these values are values important for democracy, and you will see that if brainstorming session is used quite often, these values are also inculcated in students. Lastly, not the least important, but if you have emergency situation, a problem has to be attacked, solved, and only teacher's ideas are not, because one person cannot come out with many ideas. See, there are 40 people who come out with their ideas. It's a quick solution if you want on a emergency situation. Brainstorming, bringing brains together, working together, coming out with wild ideas. We should tell them that we don't want the traditional ideas. Traditionally, people have been solving this problem. This problem has to be tackled by many different perspectives. So all those ideas come together, and this helps in solving the problem in a very quickly. So many advantages for using brainstorming as a strategy. Teachers should really learn how to use them, start using it. There are no disadvantages or limitations. If at all limitations are there, they are with the teachers. Teachers should learn, because we need trained teachers, how to create that conducive environment, how to help students to contribute, how to help them to evaluate or assess ideas. So it is basically a teacher who should be trained in using this. But by using it again and again, I am sure teachers would master this art and help the students, help your trainees to generate that kind of massive ideas together so that the problem can be solved. Thank you.